Welcome back to Sacramento State University. This is Brian. I'm with Charles. Ivan, congratulations. Valeria, fired up for Mexico. We've had, I don't know, hundreds of games over the past 8 days, a ton, and there's one left. The men's final, the Homeless World Cup final between the reigning champions, Chile, and the team they've beaten in the past two finals. I'm sorry, the reigning champions, Mexico, and the team they've beaten in the past two finals, Chile. This is the third straight Homeless World Cup where these two nations will contest the trophy. Mexico has won 4 of the past 5 Homeless World Cups. Chile is a 2-time champion. So these are, like on the women's side, these are the premier street soccer programs in the world, at least in terms of results here at this event. And one of them is 14 minutes away from lifting the biggest honor in the sport. I'm excited. Mexican women just celebrated their championship. They're now gonna watch their counterparts on the men's bracket try to do another double. We'll have the lineups and anthems for you shortly.
So we'll do the anthems now with Chile and Mexico. And the Mexicans already singing, jumping up in joy with the momentum that they had from the last match with the women winning that game.
Both these teams undefeated in this tournament through 11 matches. As we listen to the Mexican anthem.
Was the Mexican national anthem, also known as the Himno Nacional Mexicano, which is in English, Mexicans at the cry of war. Now we'll hear the Chilean national anthem.
The anthems are done. We're a few seconds away from the 18th Homeless World Cup final between two familiar faces, two familiar countries wearing their familiar colors, the Mexico wearing their green, white, and red, Chile in the red, blue, and white. This is the third straight time they have met at this stage of the competition. Mexico, a 6-3 winner over Chile in 2018 in the Zocalo in Mexico City. They then met again in Cardiff in 2019, Mexico winning 5-1. And then the pandemic, a 4-year hiatus, but not enough to derail either of these two programs as they've made their way through this tournament again. Again, each unbeaten over 11 matches. The Chileans perfect, winning every game in regulation. Mexico being forced to penalties once during the group stage, but winning that shootout. And they'll decide the title again here at Sac State before what is a decent crowd. As we approach 11:30, as we pass 11:30 in the morning.
We just saw the lineup for Mexico and their team sheet. We just saw the Chilean team sheet as well.
The Mexican goalie's not going to let go of the flag. You have to put the flag down. You can't play with the flag.
It's
an unfair advantage to use the flag to like as a sheet to block the goal. That's you can't do that.
That's right. Giovanni, the goalkeeper for Mexico. And the goalkeeper for Chile, Jose. It is Nicolas for Chile. It is David for Chile, who is the captain, and Martin for Chile. And on the Mexican side, Rodolfo. Roberto. And we are underway in the Homeless World Cup final. Live from Sacramento, California, in the United States. The first Homeless World Cup in the United States. Chance on this for Chile. Opening goal for Chile. It is David with that goal. A quick counterattack. Lovely, lovely stuff. And a free kick Mexico's way. This is Rodolfo. Excuse me, and Roberto now. Roberto, Rodolfo, Rodolfo, his shot. This is Rodolfo G, and he's upended. Now, there are two Rodolfos, Rodolfo G and Rodolfo V. So that is Rodolfo G.
I guess they must be brothers, huh?
They could be. They could be. This is Rodolfo G. For Roberto. And now Rodolfo V and his shot blocked.
Little sloppy clearance from Chile.
Roberto's shot is...
Mexico is not able to punish them.
Out there.
It looks like we...
Rodolfo! Rodolfo makes it 1-1.
Did that take a little deflection?
I think it did. Yeah. I think it did, Brian.
Spin off someone? I was going to say, Chile clearly looks like they're going to be looking for David on the counter there. Mexico's going to have a lot of the ball.
Save made by the goalkeeper, but it trickles in. It trickles in for Martin. Martin with that goal. And Chile
we have gone off
has a second.
We have gone off the rails here in under 2 minutes. This is the opposite of the women's game, right? The women's game was just this, like, really cagey, controlled, defensive affair. This thing is on all the caffeine.
Yeah, well, that pass from Martin right there into the feet of David that just came off the post. This is Rodolfo.
This is the least final I've ever finaled.
Well, it's a good final, Rodolfo V.
This is not what these games usually look like.
Might have a shade of a 2022 World Cup final, potentially. 2-2 already, but both teams finding their groove early. Not even 3 minutes into this game. 2.5 minutes in. In fact, this is Martin and David. David has Nicolas with him. Nicolas, David, the captain. Pass deflected all the way back to the goalkeeper, Giovanni, for Rodolfo. Now, Roberto. Rodolfo again for Rodolfo.
Still feel like Mexico is the team that has a bit of control in this game. Yes, it's 2-2, but both of Chile's goals have come over minor breakdowns.
No goal, says the referee.
Not necessarily things that have resulted from more sustained run of play. Mexico close to taking the lead there, but like Charles said, ruled out. But if I'm Mexico, I still feel like I'm a bit in the ascendancy here, and I'm okay with the way things are going.
Now, I believe that there were three players in that defensive half. And so it's going to be a free kick here. Wait, hold on. The referee is going to stop play for a second. Didn't like the substitution. They're both protesting. And why not? It is a final, and it's tied at 2-2. Every little bit counts. Every little bit matters. This is Freddy.
That's a really nice play. I like that.
For David.
Half volley cross through the lava. Nice idea. Chile's first chance that was really constructed, I think, out of possession.
Oof. Now, a free kick going Mexico's way.
Sort of reminiscent of the hard foul in the women's game, just opposite teams.
That was Omar. Fouled pretty...
A little bit of boarding.
Pretty intensely there. Roberto to take this corner ball.
There's some little mini shoves going on here. This is becoming physical and intense. Maybe some, I don't know, not red mist, but blue mist, I guess, since we have the blue cards.
Just over the bar there. Nice opportunity.
We're up to 91 degrees, so it is hot.
Very, very hot conditions. It's probably hotter on the pitch as well.
Oh, definitely. It's always like 10 degrees hotter on that artificial surface.
Roberto, the shot comes off. The board's there, Omar. And collected another foul. It's going to be going Chile's way, coming up on 2 minutes to go till the end of this first half. Incredible match so far, 2-2. Brilliant stuff by himself, a little flick. He didn't see that he was by himself there. Was Freddy?
Chile, their first sustained possession of the half here.
Christian. And away there, Chile committed numbers, and Mexico misses.
Maybe a bit too unselfish. Maybe a bit too unselfish.
He's given a penalty, the referee. The referee has given a penalty. He has given a penalty. And it is gonna be Rodolfo V to take this. Rodolfo, save made. Was the referee out of his crease, though? No. The referee does point it away. It'll be a restart to Chile.
It's essentially worth a goal right there for Chile.
Incredible.
Save.
Incredible stuff.
But again, just the level of aggression in defense in these one-on-one battles. Duels, right? I mean, there's analytics in soccer where coaches and analysts measure duels, measure tackles. And there's a lot of that in this game. And this, as Charles said, everything is at stake here. And this is it. This is the last game that these guys will play together. This is the last game in their homeless World Cup careers.
10 seconds to go, end of the first half. Maybe a possession here by Chile on the turn. It's Christian, closely defended, nicely defended by Omar, and end of the first half. A first half that was played toe-to-toe.
Chile at least better toward the end than they were for the first portion of that period. They couldn't find the ball at all at the beginning and managed two or three spells of possession in the Mexican half toward the end. Fortunate not to go behind on the penalty. And we've got a tie game, 7 minutes to a title.
7 minutes to go. Taking a look at the highlights of this first half. This was the first goal. It was scored by David. Look at him, just working his way through counter-attacking opportunity, and there was the first goal for Mexico. Here was the second goal for Chile. Quick one from Martin, and then they set this up nicely. Look at that from Rodolfo. On his right foot. Right corner as well. They missed a penalty, Mexico. That was saved by the Chilean goalkeeper, Jose.
Halftime show is over. Hope you enjoyed Rihanna's set there.
Yeah.
That was brilliant.
That's a great set by Rihanna.
Yeah. And we're back. Everything to play for. 7 minutes left. 7 minutes to a trophy. Mexico really like, they love this little exchange in back. There's that great Twitter account when playing it out of the back goes wrong.
This is Saul. Saul, he tees it up.
What a save
made by Jose.
He had no business getting to that.
Saul by himself. Saul, shot
Chile
blocked.
Really pulled apart. Mexico can't capitalize. Another save that's worth a goal for the Chileans. If they pull this out, those two saves.
Saul.
Like Dibu Martinez on Kola Moani and in Qatar. Chilean goalie, he better get a tattoo like Dibu did.
It's going to be a free kick going Chile's way. A minute played in this second half. All to play for. What a final. Nothing separating the two sides so far. Mexico probably with the better run of play possession-wise. Save made there by Giovanni.
Like the fact he took that on the first time, spun around. That was the right thing to do. Good save.
Giovanni. And there it is. A wonderful strike by Martin. Chile leads 3-2. Martin with that goal.
How are they winning this game? This is amazing. That was just a gorgeous shot. I mean, the famous phrase, you don't play finals, you win them, right? I mean, that's, I don't know who coined that. I don't know where it came from originally, but it doesn't matter what it looks like. That's what that means. It doesn't matter what you need to do. It doesn't matter what goes wrong. It doesn't matter how ugly it is, how much graft, how much grit. You don't worry about playing, you worry about winning. That's what finals are about. Despite being outplayed for a chunk of this match, through the 9 minute mark, Chile is ahead. Jose, another save. He's obviously a huge reason why.
This is David, all the way back to the goalkeeper, Giovanni. Mexico now chasing this game again. They chased this game three times already. Excuse me, two times before this, third time already. So Chile's had a few leads. Nicolas. And a diving tackle there. But Giovanni will restart things for Rodolfo. Rodolfo looked to be muscled off the ball. One back here by Chile. Martin, David.
Smart play by Martin to keep possession there instead of going for a shot that wasn't likely to go in. That was a real
Nicolas,
smart pass in the corner.
David.
Set them up for this spell right here.
David, Martin.
And that chance. Unlucky for Martin. That was a good save. But that was, he started that with a really smart ball to relieve some pressure.
Giovanni making the save.
3.5 minutes left.
And now, Mexico needs to get on with it. They gotta find something. But Chile really kind of bunkering in defensively though, Brian, especially in the transition. They know that the transition is super important. Coming up on 3 minutes to go. They're gonna change strikers here, Mexico. And they're gonna throw on Enrique. And there's another from Chile.
How did that get through?
A huge goal
Near
from
post.
Giovanni.
Tight angle.
Giovanni's goal. Right there.
They were on their heels at the start of this game and now are up 2 goals and 2.5 minutes away from a world championship. Absolute resilience by Chile.
But it
kept
just,
their composure when things were going against them and have now made the plays and played mistake-free. Taking their chances. Mexican goalie might want that one back.
Oh, and just over the bar. It wasn't too far. Giovanni, who just scored that fourth, was waiting for another one. It doesn't take too much here for Mexico to get back in this. Rodolfo. Oh, and just off the post. All the way back to the goalkeeper, Jose. Can they get one, Mexico? Well, it doesn't matter now. That's Giovanni with the goal. His fifth.
Think back to those 2 saves by Jose, the penalty, and then that acrobatic save at the beginning of the second half. And as I say that, Mexico pulls one back. It's 5-3. We have a wild 90 seconds left here.
Bit of a finish. Can they get another one, Mexico, with the crowd behind them?
Another smart pass by the Chileans to relieve some pressure. Again, set them up for an attacking spell, a possession spell. Sometimes just simply a ball to space, simply a ball that moves defenders from where they want it to be, allows you to set up again and kill some time. It's smart soccer.
Giovanni, far side for the captain, David.
Game-saving save.
Nicolas.
But again, Chile killed a bunch of clock there just because they were smart. Moved Mexico around enough simply to keep the ball. At this point, time is worth as much as a goal. Final minute.
So close. It's so, so close. Mexico needs to get one, though. They need to get one quick. This would be something from Rodolfo if they can find it. Tackled away. Rodolfo with possession still, but Chile with David, who wins it back. But was he dispossessed? And was there a foul there?
Might have been a foul and a quick restart. But yeah.
Maybe. Referee said play on. Well, that's certainly a foul. And with 10 seconds to go.
Academic at this point, I think.
Yeah, it looks to be, yeah. Brian. Yes. And there it is. Chile wins. Chile, the champions.
Third championship for the Chilean men, Tricampeón. What's cool about Chile is that they wear 3 stars above their crest on their jerseys with their street soccer emblem. 2 of them for the men, 1 for the women. They combine their men's and women's stars into 1 crest, and they will add a 4th. The women fell short a few minutes ago, but the men, deservedly, after a slow start, come back clinical in the attacking half, shut Mexico down, and win their 3rd men's homeless World Cup championship. Congrats to them.
What a game between these 2 sides. Just incredible. Beautiful stuff today. And the Chilean women will hug the Chilean men. And Chile wins this by the scoreline of 5-3.
Mexico, your women's champion. Chile, your men's champion. The 18th homeless World Cup has concluded. We do not know where next year's will be. I've asked some of the guests here in the booth who've come through, and they won't say. Maybe that's why no one came in to join us today. They were tired of those kinds of questions. Who knows? Probably not. But this was awesome. This was especially having all 3 fields in front of us and the atmosphere here in the stadium as the games were going on simultaneously. And it was fun to sort of watch this build toward the climax here in the center pitch. Finals, wildly different games. The women's game was really tight, defensive, and you know, sort of a brilliant showcase for Mexico's ability to sort of strangle the life out of a really, really good Chilean women's team. And then the men's game, just freewheeling craziness. A lot of goals, a lot of chances, hard fouls, the missed penalty. A lot of emotion.
Yeah, yeah. And you'd expect that from a tournament as beautiful and as impactful as this, and changing people's lives, playing for more than just winning or losing, playing for bigger goals.
So they've passed out graduation caps, like black graduation caps. That I don't know what the story is behind that, but a lot of the players who have stuck around to watch are wearing mortar boards. Is that what they're called?
Yes, yeah. Mortar boards.
They're wearing mortar boards.
Maybe just
they've
to have some
shade. Graduated from the Homeless World Cup, yeah.
Yeah.
It's a moment of transition for them. A lot of them, as we've been talking about all week, have used these street soccer programs to find community, to find inspiration, find structure, build life skills, enjoy playing the greatest game in the world. That's a huge part of it as well. And they have earned their way. They have impressed the people who run these street soccer programs in their country enough to earn their way to this event, to be selected to wear their country's colors and represent them on the world stage. And so the graduation cap's perhaps a poignant symbol of that as we go into the highlights of the men's World Cup final.
Yeah, and that goal right there, scored by Martin. Look at that right there. Giovanni added another one right through the legs of Giovanni. Giovanni on Giovanni, and then he scored another one right here. That was a great strike to put Mexico back in it, but unfortunately, too little too late for the Mexican side, and that's how Chile won it. They are the Homeless World Cup champions here on our green pitch, the final match of the day.